So he will share with us the challenges and the opportunities of building virtual communities, which is the Indian Wikipedia communities, from his vast experience. You can introduce yourself much better.
When I heard about this, I was very excited because I wanted to share with you an experience that I've been able to gather for the last several years. I've worked on this for like more than five, six years. So I wanted to share my experience on this with you guys. It would be quite valuable for you guys. So listen up, okay? It's going to be very valuable for you. Before I get started, a little introduction about myself. I started out on Wikipedia in 2004. That was way back when we used to hang out on IRC with Angela Beasley and all the people who just became some of the well-known names in the Wikipedia world, actually, in the Wiki world. I started out in 2004. I started out editing on English Wikipedia. That's when Angela told me that there is a Wikipedia in Kannada. Do you know about that? I said, I don't know. She said, do you know Kannada? I said, I'm very good in Kannada. I'm not, I don't like to take pride, but I'm more interested in writing in Kannada than in English. If given a chance, I would always write in Kannada than in English. That's what I appropriate for a wiki. There were some articles there which were not appropriate to wiki. I removed those. I started out with a proper wikified article and then got started with certain templating and all that. And that's how I got into Wikipedia. Along with that, I'm a developer, so I was closely monitoring all the developments happening around MediaWiki. And within no time, I was editing on English Wikipedia and Kannada Wikipedia and contributing to Commons and participating in a lot of things. And I was part of the chapters committee of Wikimedia Foundation. I was one of the members of chapters committee. I used to review bylaws and help out in whatever way I could in the discussions. And then I was part of so many other things related to Wikipedia, especially outreach. Probably the first ever outreach in India was organized by our team. I wouldn't say me, because a lot of people helped out. It was a team effort. It was an effort of volunteers who really came together to make that happen. But I was in the forefront along with a few others in organizing it. Wikimedia Foundation helped out in a small way, and some volunteers put in their money as well. I put in my money as well to organize that outreach event. It was organized in JC Road, Kannada Bhavana. The photos are still there online, in case you guys are interested. It's on MetaWiki, and that's where it all started. The outreach events and all. Sunil did help in many ways, and we really wanted outreach to work. Okay, that's why you guys are here, you know. Tomorrow, you're going to do outreach, and each program that you're going to do is going to be very valuable. The time you're going to spend with people there is going to be valuable. So, how do you make the best out of it? How do you make the best out of the time that you're spending with the people there? That's what I'm going to talk about today. Out of all the experience, I wouldn't say I'm vastly experienced, because there are a lot of things to do in the wiki world. There's just too many things to be done in the wiki world. If you get into it, you'll be like, oh, this isn't to be done, that's to be done, that's to be done. So you'll be like engrossed in doing a lot of things. So one thing you could do is prepare more people to edit on Wikipedia. Okay? I would say preparing volunteers, getting volunteers for Wikipedia. That's the challenge. That's the thing that you need to do. That's what I'm going to talk about today. Okay, the rest of my introduction is still not complete. I'll have to say I was part of, I'm a sysop on Sanskrit Wikipedia. I'm a sysop on Kannada Wikipedia, Kannada Wiktionary, and a few other projects. I was one of the founding members of Wikimedia India, Wikimedia chapter in India. And I helped out in a big way during the initial formation of, in the formative stage of the society. And I've been involved in anything that is wiki. Just because I like it, I like the project, I like the concept of openness, that the knowledge is free for all. That's the thing that drives me, even to this day. It's nothing else. It's the concept. You know, there's a poem by Rabindranath Tagore where he says, I want to live in a world where knowledge is free for all. Okay? That's what drives me today. That's what drives me today. And whenever I look at Kannada literature and the way things are going on in our state, Karnataka, I feel that the content, the knowledge in Kannada should be available, readily available to whoever wants it. If there's a kid in my town, in my village, who wants some content in Kannada, it should be readily available to him or her. It shouldn't take much, it shouldn't be much difficulty for them to get to that. Because I've spent a lot of time in libraries looking for books that I couldn't get elsewhere. You know, mosquitoes and the dirt would never bother me when sitting in libraries searching for books. But today, you can just hit a button, select a button, hit press enter and get to the knowledge that you require. That is the potential we are talking about with Wikipedia. Okay? Wikipedia can go in any way. It can be good, it can be bad. And we are the people who can take it there. Okay? If we have to make Wikipedia better, we can do it. Okay? As a community, as a collective. Let me get started with the presentation now. What I'm going to talk to you today is about how you can bootstrap or build an Indian language community. And what I'm going to say is will also be true about a community which is already there, existing to a certain stage. Okay, don't think that I'm going to talk about any community which has not gotten started whatsoever. It could be a community which has gotten started and come to a certain level. Okay, and I would love if you have any inputs to go along with what I have gathered around today. Okay, this need not be a complete guidebook or a comprehensive guide whatsoever. Okay, I'm going to just put out the things that I have experienced and I'm going to discuss that with you guys. The first thing we need to understand is what exactly is the local language community and how different is it from the English community. It's very important to understand that because most of us have started out on English Wikipedia and then moved on to the local language Wikipedias, because maybe we didn't come across those things earlier. Or just we were looking up some website and something on the Google and we chanced upon a page on Wikipedia, we saw the edit button, started editing. That's how we probably would have started with Wikipedia. But language community is quite different from the English community in itself. So how different is that? We'll need to understand that first thing. See, I can relate to this on Kannada and few other languages as well that I've monitored, Sanskrit for instance, and then I've monitored Telugu and Tamil closely, even the Malayalam version. There are participants from different regions, but they are related. For instance, in Kannada, we have people from Bangalore region, Bangalore-Mysore region, who speak certain kind of Kannada. There are people from northern region of Karnataka who speak a different kind of Kannada altogether. The usage of words and the way they approach things, the way they write things is quite different. There are people from the coastal part of Karnataka who speak quite different whatsoever. We have one person from here. Yeah, he's from Dakshina Kannada, right? DK. So, the way they write Kannada and speak Kannada may be different. Writing Kannada has become very textual and library kind of thing, where they follow a specific format, which is what is being used on Wikipedia. I'll come to that thing later. But I'm just trying to say that there are people from different regions which are related but have different usages for words, for instance. Okay? The same thing with Tamil. There are people from Tamil Nadu editing on Tamil Wikipedia. There are people from Sri Lanka who are editing on Tamil Wikipedia. There are people from South Africa who are editing on Tamil Wikipedia. There are people from France who are editing on Tamil Wikipedia. There are people from Malaysia who are editing on Tamil Wikipedia. There are people from different regions. We'll need to understand that fact. I'm going to go into details later. And the dialects are very important, okay? I'm not going into the technical definition of dialects. Today, in the way we speak in Bangalore doesn't make much sense if we go to North Karnataka. If I ask for root when I go to North Karnataka, they'll be like flabbergasted. What did you ask? They'll say. So the way they speak is different. The dialects are different. Within the regions, the dialect factor should also be counted. Okay? I'll get into the details of this later. Now, the target audience when compared to English Wikipedia or English communities is very small. Okay? Can I take a pen? Can I get a pen?
Sure.
You want the board?
Marker?
Yeah, I need the board.
Marker is there.
This one? See, this is English Wikipedia or English community. Ours is this much, or maybe even more smaller, or a little like that. Okay? The comparison is such. The target audience, the number of visitors to your website, whichever community that is, Wikipedia or otherwise, it's very small. We should understand that. It's very small when compared to the English audience. Now, the kind of users we get are also sparse. I say sparse. It's thin and cluttered. It's very thin and cluttered. Okay? We don't get a huge bandwidth of visitors to our projects. Remember that. Remember that. I'm going to tell you why I'm talking about all these things. Now, target audience need not be contributors. The target audience are your readers. They are not your contributors. Remember that. Those people who are visiting Wikipedia are not contributors fully. They may or may not be contributors. A fraction of those visiting will be contributors, okay? Or shall become contributors. And contributors are very scarce for language communities, remember that. For various reasons which I'm going to discuss later. Okay, remember that. They are going to be scarce. You know about this, this is quite obvious. But you might be wondering why I'm stressing that so much. Because it's going to factor in a lot when you're planning all these events, when you're going for outreach. It's very important. They're widely different. You might ask, what is widely different? Why did you say this? I'll talk to you about this in detail in a bit from now. You get people with varied competence. Why varied competence? Suppose you want to get a logo done. Suppose you want to get a logo done for your project. Who's there in the community? Will you get a graphic designer to do that? In our community, we would never, do that. We would probably hunt for a volunteer who's good with graphics, ask them to do the logo and send it back. But in smaller communities, because you get people with varied competence, there is a good chance that you might even not find the graphic design in your community. You'll then need to take help from someone else. Of course, with graphics, you can always take help. What about translations? What about request for advice on translations or something else? How do you go about that? You can't take help from someone who's from other community. They wouldn't know about this language, right? What would you do about that? So that's the most important thing. Remember that. There are many more other differences. Plenty of differences. You can go on listing like that. Listing those things will help you when doing all these outreach programs or talking to Wikipedians, future Wikipedians. It will help you a lot. Think about all these factors and think about how you are going to approach this. But I have outlined these four points because these, I felt that these are very important things to factor in thinking about all this. Now, this is a very interesting thing, although it's just three circles that I've put together. You might have some questions about that or criticism about that, but I just wanted to make it simple. Okay? Here's how it works. There are people from little villages and towns who will be your contributors. Okay? There'll be people from villages and towns who will be your contributors. Today, broadband has reached the remote corners of the state here in Karnataka. I don't know about the other state, but it is reaching up pretty fast. Okay? You'll have contributors from little villages and towns. That would be exciting, actually. But then, their exposure to technology would be a little less. Not that they can't do good job. They'll do much better job on language communities than many people in the cities. but they'll be having less exposure. Remember this. Okay, I'll talk to you why I'm pointing this out to you. Now there's this urban population which is well connected to the internet, have high speed internet connections, and may or may not be the best in the language. They may or may not be the best. They may be good in the local language, but they may not be good in local language because they are part cosmopolitan. Yeah? And there is this NRI crowd, people who have gone abroad, who may or may not be good with Kannada as well. Okay? Or so, may not be good with the local language. I'm sorry, I'm getting to Kannada. So, and these communities overlap each other. Okay, these sections overlap each other. Okay, I put this graphic together because we need to understand this pretty well. Whenever we see contributors on Wikipedia or contributors who or volunteers that are showing up, we need to make up our mind and see and observe what kind of contributors these people are. Are they coming from the rural background? Are they coming from the urban background? Are they coming from outside India? I have seen specifically, in my experience, I have seen that people from outside, people who have gone abroad, tend to edit Wikipedias a lot because they feel that they have missed something when staying outside India. They feel that I've missed something. Take Gujarat, for instance. Gujarati, Spandan admin was active.
Yeah. Current admin is also in London, right?
Most of them are right now. In Kannada, much of the edits were done by a guy called Sushrut and then Ashwath. Both of them, when they were in US, this guy is a neurosurgeon in US, and he did a lot of very valuable edits. Even to this day, I consider him the most valuable contributor to Kannada Wikipedia. He's done a lot of work, Mr. Sushrut. I haven't even met him. I have just exchanged some emails to him. And we have fought a lot on Wikipedia. That's a different thing altogether. I was just talking to Sunil. Differences are good, actually, right? We fought a lot, but he's done very valuable work. And then Mr. Ashwath Mathur, I believe, he did a lot of work when he was in US. He was doing his MS in US, then he did a lot of work. Same with Tamil Wikipedia as well. People from outside have contributed a lot. NRIs or people who have gone outside for study or anything else, they tend to contribute a lot because they feel that they have missed out their language a lot. So they start using this as a window. And we should use that as much as possible. We should use that as much as possible because they not only contribute valuable content to this, they end up increasing the activity on the community end of it. So this demarcation is, whereas the people from rural background have very good knowledge of local language because they are educated in local language, brought up in local language, they are solid in local language, most of them are. So that's also something that you need to factor in. And urban people are very well exposed to technology. They can help you in many ways. So I'm not saying I'm not saying bias them or put up a boundary for each of them and start biasing. No, know their strengths and get them to be active on each language Wikipedia. That will help us a lot. Each of these sections is very important. Everybody is important. Now we should understand the ecosystem. I call it ecosystem because it's more like an ecosystem anyway. Wikipedia is more like an ecosystem. You have everything you need there. You have a village pump, you have something else, you can just relate to it as an ecosystem. Now, let's understand the ecosystem. I'm taking a generic view of a local language community based on my experience of not only Kannada Wikipedia, but of Sampada that I've founded and been managing for. I founded a community in Kannada called Sampada. I've been managing it for the last 8 years. And it's still been a thriving community. And I've had a lot of experience to share from that. But I'm keeping the context today to Wikipedia specifically so that you guys have more takeaways from the time that I spend with you. All right? But this understanding is from my...
She is asking about Sampada.
No, what is Sampada?
It's a community, online community for people who write and converse in Kannada. Read, write and converse in Kannada. We have had a lot of members there conversing for the last 8 years. So many things have come up from it. We even ran a magazine called Krishi Sampada. Did a lot of work. It will take like 15-20 minutes to talk about that. I won't talk about that now. You can check it though on sampada.net. We have mobile apps for that as well. Yeah. So, one thing is, the local language communities are nothing like English community. We always make that mistake. I did that mistake when I started out. I thought this is just like English community and we are going to take a carbon copy and then get started. That's not going to work. You have to factor in a lot of things that is local before getting started or planning the project. It's very important. And there is no magic wand to build a community overnight. It takes time and it is organic. It is gradual. Okay? A community is built over a period of time with a lot of people getting active, not just by one or two people, but a lot of people getting active, a lot of people fighting, sharing their opinions, sharing the differences and all that. Okay? That's very important. Okay? That's what I've said in the next point. Progress is gradual. And the activity in any language community, if you have observed, peaks when the awareness about the language community peaks, okay, and when the necessity of that language community increases. This is a big takeaway for you guys, remember. The necessity of that project should increase. Not just awareness. If we keep going on doing PR about the projects, that's not going to help us. There should be necessity for people to visit that project. So you should start, or you should encourage starting certain things that are going to get people to come back to Wikipedia or the community to read about it and change things about it. Very important. When I started out on Kannada Wikipedia, I thought about this a lot and then started out with a series of articles on Kannada literatures. Because in Kannada's literature, in Karnataka, they are respected a lot. Everyone who's worked on Kannada literature is respected a lot. People want to read about them. Many people do not know who's Tejasvi and who's Kuvempu. If they've heard about Kuvempu, they do not know what are the books that he's written. They may know just one or two titles that he's come up with. But what about the others? They wouldn't know. For that, they'll come back to Wikipedia. Okay? For that, they'll come back to Wikipedia. Take instance of Bendre, for instance. He's a well-known poet in Kannada. About him, we do not know much. We have just read about the books he's come up with, the poems he has come up with. But what about his life? I don't know about his life. I didn't know that he had a son until someone told me that he has a son and he's in Hubli. Then I looked it up on Google and then, so he's also a researcher. That's how I came to know about that. So this is what we need to exploit. The necessity factor should peak. The necessity factor should peak and the awareness should peak. If there is no awareness about the project, they wouldn't know where to look the information from. Very important. And the socio-cultural aspects is very important. I don't know how to explain this in a single shot. There are a lot of experiences that I can share. On language Wikipedias, there are, you know, people fight over wordings, specific wordings for religious institutions or religious people or anything like that. Or take some tradition or culture, for instance, the way we put it across. People fight over that, people have differences over that, and that ends up taking a lot of time. So you need to see what is the socio-cultural aspect of this region, of this state, of this language. A lot of things, actually. We can't just do it the way they have done it on English Wikipedia. There are a lot of things that we need to think and plan in a different way. The health of the community and the project when you start out is very important. You should see what the health, what kind of status the project is in. Is it healthy? Is there a lot of activity going on? If there is a lot of activity going on, what kind of activity is going on? Are they creating just the stuffs? Are they just putting up any sort of content, copy-pasting stuff from elsewhere? Are they creating content that is not at all appropriate for Wiki? Are they creating biographical notes about themselves? These are the things that you need to look into. Okay? Or these are the things that you need to encourage the people who are contributing to Wikipedia to look into. And the health of the project is determined by these factors. okay, the project is healthy if there are good articles being created, good and useful articles. Remember, necessity is very important aspect. You also need to look into what kind of aspects they have derived from the English community on the language communities, because they just copy paste the templates and put it here. Sometimes what happens is for featured articles and few other articles, there'll be a lot of templates, very technical templates, that they would have copied from there to here. They wouldn't have copied the sub-templates. Okay? They wouldn't have copied many other things that should have gotten copied. What this does is, it doesn't paint a good picture on the local language communities. The pages get broken. They don't look fine. This happened very much when Google was mass translating articles.
Yeah.
And it had let mass translating articles. It would just copy-paste from there, or it would let people copy-paste from there. The templates would be blank. It wouldn't appear properly. It was a big problem on local language communities. Sorting that out will fall on the most active volunteers who are contributing valuable content. That way, they are rendered useless, and the quality of the project is taking a hit. Okay, that happens a lot. So it's a very important thing. UI translation. What happens on language communities is that they go with the same scale all the time. They say, we'll translate the UI completely. First, we'll translate the UI completely and then get started with the project. That may not work all the time. There is a guy called, there's one guy, I don't remember his name. He used to push for translations on all media wikis, for all languages. On the mailing list, he used to push me, saying, you have to complete 100% translation. On Translate Wiki, it should look 100% translated, and I'll be happy, he would say to me. I kept arguing with him that no, 100% translation may not help us, because some translations may be detrimental. Okay? For instance, the login button, login text that was there, when translated to Kannada, it would show up as boxes for many people. They wouldn't know how to log in to get help itself. The help screen would be available some page later. They wouldn't know how to log in for the first thing. They wouldn't know what to read and what not to read. It would just appear as boxes everywhere. So at that time, we needed the login button in English, or the login text in English. It was very important for us. So I went in manually and changed it to login. And for random, there was a Sanskrit word that we had used. Many people did not understand it. We were pushed to make those translations. We did it. Nobody understood what is random, and that very vital feature of hitting up across a random page to read was gone for a long time. Many people did not come to see that at all. So if we had kept it back as random, anybody would understand what random is. The other thing about UI translation is, I talked about the extent of UI translation. We should be watchful about the extent to which we go translating the UI. The other thing is utility of the UI translation. How useful is the translation done? We need to put up a very practical approach for this. We need to not be very specific about the translations and the way we put together the translation, but we need to think about it. We need to think about it in a more practical way. Well, that was about my attempt to understand, get you to understand the generic ecosystem on local language communities. I hope I have covered plenty of those, okay? But I'll just get on to opportunities quickly, because I'm running out of time now. I am, right? I do have time, is it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Time till 12.
You guys will be bored to death if I keep talking. Huh? All right. The reason why I wanted you guys to understand the ecosystem is because whenever you do outreach events, or whenever you approach people who are interested in volunteering for Wikipedia, who are interested in Wikipedia at all, you need to understand how these local language communities are, what state they are, and what you are getting these people into. Okay, because tomorrow they are going to come back to you and ask, oh, I got into this, and how do I get out of this? You know, I had this experience there. How do I get out of this? They'll treat you like mentors. They'll get back to you. They'll write emails to you. They'll probably call you up and ask questions. So there, you'll need this a lot. Okay, I'll talk about specific takeaways for trainers. In a bit. Okay, these are part of understanding the whole thing. Now let's talk about opportunities. Why do we need to build a local language community? What is the big thing about that? Are we doing a charitable thing? Is it a good thing to do, is it? Or just you're just here because you've been pushed to do that by somebody? Is that the case? What would you say, Jayant? What inspires you to contribute to local language community?
Because I am a Bengali. Okay? Pastor.
Yes.
So if I am not contributing in Bengali,
yes.
Who is doing that?
Excellent. One thing. That's one very good thing.
That's why inspired. That's point one. Okay? And another part is we should contribute our or promote our culture, Bengali culture, or culture about in language country, say Bengali. So it's good to do that.
Excellent. What inspired you to contribute, Shubha? Tell me.
Sanskritam, sarvesham bhashanam matribhasha iti ekaha abhipraya asti. Anyaha abhipraya sanskritam. Mruta bhasha iti asti. Abhipraya dvayam api ashuddham. Etad vadamaha chet kopi na avagacchati. Sarve api janeyuhu kim satyam iti. Tad darshaniyam chet etad karyam
karyam. So what she wanted to say is that everybody feels that Sanskrit is a dead language. She doesn't think so. She thinks that it's a medium for conversation and it should be used more. I just summed it up though. I didn't do a little translation of what she said. But what she said was very useful. What Jayant said was very useful. You want to add something to it?
1991 census report is there and the census of India.org website.
Is this anything to add to what I'm saying?
What she said.
No, we'll talk about that later. That's an entire thread differently. Altogether. We'll talk about that later. I just wanted to bring your attention to what inspires people to contribute to local language community. We have people who are contributing to local language communities now. So what inspires them? The belonging to the language, like Jayant said, the belonging, sense of belonging, the interest to make their language appear on the internet and spread knowledge across, right? So these are the things and many more aspects that inspire people to get into it. But there are a lot of opportunities. You wouldn't believe me, there are huge opportunities in bringing out communities in Indian languages. I'm going to talk about that. You get a chance to connect to the roots. I'm kidding when I say this. You get a chance to connect to the roots. Believe me, when I read books in Kannada today, I feel empowered sometimes. I feel that I've gotten something that people who are reading it just in English are losing out, which has compelled me to read books translated from other languages to English. I try to read that, even though they are not transferring the knowledge completely to us, I start reading books translated from other languages because there are a lot of takeaways from there. You get a lot of things from that. Remember, it's a very good thing. You get a chance to connect to the roots, which is a very important thing. Next, you get to explore the unexplored. Okay? For instance, I didn't know what a katta means in Kannada. Is it katta? Katte, anekattu kattarla, limma urkade. Katta. I didn't know what katta is. Somebody was talking about it when I was working on something related to water and I wondered what that is. Somebody said jalparige and I never knew about that. Turns out these are traditional water bodies. Jalparige is a traditional water body and katta is a little dam that is constructed in a coastal region to save water when it is running away far, pretty fast, you know, when it's just getting wasted. I learned about these things. This is a very nice concept, you know. And when I visited a friend of mine in Kasaragod, he had constructed a little dam above the in his farm, which I personally experienced and saw. It's a very good technique, you know. And I started in researching information about that. Some people elsewhere I've done that. So these are the things that are so disconnected, because the knowledge about this is documented only in local language. It was in local language. Now people are translating it to English. A friend of mine who was an editor in a magazine in the state earlier, he said, you know, when you're writing about agriculture, you should bring it out in English as well, because the stuff that we're doing here will also get transferred over to people who are reading it in English. That's a very important thing. Why? Because you get to explore the things that have not been explored yet. Yeah? Why was there a necessity for a German missionary to come to India and put up a dictionary in the local language? He put up a dictionary in Kannada language, and that is one of the best dictionaries we have so far. Okay? And he did that because he wanted to build a channel or a bridge to transfer the knowledge from here to there. You get to share better understanding if you have the knowledge of local the knowledge that's lying in local language communities. If you get exposed to that, you get to share a better understanding of stuff that's going on. For instance, there are tribal communities near Mysore. Many things they do is recorded these days. Yeah, there are people coming from outside India who are trying to record some of those. They get a better understanding if it is recorded in local language and then translated with the help of people who are there who can understand the language as well. I have some friends of mine who are working on the root, on the grassroots, on many of these things. Okay, you get to share better understanding of stuff. I'm going to talk about that later if you're interested more about this. The other thing is, this is a very important thing, by the way. You get to add to the overall knowledge of humanity. I have a friend by name Jan Forget. He was editing a lot on Sanskrit wiki source. He was editing a lot on Sanskrit wiki source. Jan Forget. He's from France.
He's based in Gujarat.
His wife is in Gujarat, by the way. He's from Gujarat. Sorry. And I used to ask him, what is it? I can't understand a French guy doing something on Sanskrit Wikisource. What does it? Why do you do this? You sit all night doing something on Sanskrit Wikisource. I just can't understand this, I would ask. He said, I have a lot of things that interest me there. I think this knowledge will help everyone, he would say. This knowledge would help everyone. That's why I'm doing this. It's nothing else that drives me. It's just this, he would say. So you add to the overall knowledge of humanity by being part of local language communities. Other opportunities. You might be interested to know that there's not much content in local language on internet. On Kannada, when I started the community called Sampada, there were hardly like few websites in Kannada language. If you search in Kannada Unicode, you would hardly get, you know, a 5 to 10 pages maximum. Today, we get thousands of research results. The internet in language, local language has grown. The local language internet has grown, but it's still less than the English, the volume that we have in English, okay? Than the volume that we have in French or German, okay? If you're contributing to the local language communities, you are in a way adding to this. Or if you are training people, or if you are getting people motivated to contribute to local language communities, you are adding to this. This is a very good thing to do, by the way. You are contributing to Indian languages to thrive on the internet. It's going to be a very good thing to do. Next, there are some people, I can relate to that very much in our own state. There are a lot of people in our state, especially my father. Take my father, for instance. He doesn't like to read on an English newspaper. He knows how to read English. It's not that he doesn't know how to read English. He always prefers the Kannada newspaper. He prefers it. He prefers to watch Kannada news channels. There are a lot of people of my age who prefer Kannada newspapers and Kannada news channels. Whenever they visit me, my friends from village and town, when they visit me, they switch on the Kannada TV channels and then keep starting the channels there. There's a preference. And that is evident in the number of Kannada channels that are popping up. The same with local language channels elsewhere. There's a preference, there's an inherent preference for local language. And for those people, knowledge will be better distributed if it is in local language. For that, we have to do this. It's a big opportunity. There's a lot of opportunity there. People who have invested in local language TV channels are making good money now. It's a huge opportunity. I'm not just talking about money-making opportunity. I'm talking about, this is not a money-making opportunity in any way. Wikipedia is not. But I'm talking about creating something big. That's the opportunity. It's creating a huge knowledge bank that will be used by a lot of people. That's the opportunity. Now you get to learn a lot of things. Learning is a big thing. If you are engaged in local language communities, you get to learn a lot of things. Today, if I am able to speak confidently in English, it's because I was good with Kannada. I couldn't speak a word in English when I came out to Bangalore and started out my engineering. I couldn't speak out a word in English, you wouldn't believe it. I was so tensed up, I couldn't, the word would not come out of my mouth. I couldn't speak, I could hardly speak in English. Today I can because I was exposed to the local language community. I learned a lot of things there. It gave me confidence. It improved my skills as well. Improving skills is also very important, much important thing that you'll get out of this. Yeah? I'll not get into that in detail. I'll probably skip that and then get to challenges straight away. This is the most important part. Yes?
Probably if you could speak a little bit more about what kind of skills
would
be useful, because for them they need to tell what kind of skills people get by getting involved in.
There are a lot of things that I can tell you about that, but
some 4 or 5 essential ones.
Well, have you heard of the word lost in translation? So you'll understand this a lot better when you're working on a local language community. You'll understand this a lot when you're working on a local language community. In fact, I ended up watching a movie by who's the director of Godfather? The director of Godfather? Ford Coppola. Coppola's daughter directed a movie called Lost in Translation. Yes. And I watched it and I could relate to it pretty well. Wow, this is amazing. You know, same thing happens when you're translating stuff from English to local language and local language to English. You end up countering a lot of things which requires aptitude, thinking, and a lot of other skills to get it right, okay? And when you're getting it right many times in succession, you'll probably get better at that. And it helps you a lot. It is helping me running a company today. I just can't imagine how that could help me in future at that time. Today it's helping me out. It helped me out many things that I learned on Wikipedia. Today is helping me out, so I don't have any regret of having spent more than 5 years editing on Kannada Wikipedia. I literally spent 5 years editing on Kannada Wikipedia. I was a consultant at that time. I had a lot of free time. I was a freelancer. I used to spend a lot of time on Kannada Wikipedia. In the morning, before coffee, I would open up Kannada Wikipedia, check the recent changes, what's happening and all that. But I learned a lot of things from there. These are the kind of skills I'm talking about. I can give you a lot of skills. I can't be very specific there. But you've got to get into it to experience that, okay? Not very good with English to list out these skills by name, but you'll get a lot of those. I'll probably try and attempt to blog it sometime in future because you guys asked about that. But it's very good thing. Being part of that will make you learn a lot of things too. It's made me learn a lot of things. Yeah. Shall I move on to the challenges though? This is the most icky part. It takes a little. It's a little difficult to digest. Yeah. It's like eating a lot late in the night. Doesn't digest properly. The challenge is very difficult. Yeah. All right. The first and foremost challenge that I want to talk about is plagiarism. You wouldn't know where they've copied text from. How would you know? They'll just copy text and then they'll put it off on Wikipedia. They'll remove the author's name and they'll put it on Wikipedia. And sometimes they don't even copy paste people, you know, stuff from encyclopedia. They'll copy paste articles from newspapers elsewhere and then paste it here. What would you do about those things? What would your people, the people who are training, who you're training, will do about this? How do you deal with plagiarism is very important. Okay? There are a lot of ways that have been tried out on local language Wikipedias, on English Wikipedia to detect plagiarism. You can try those things. But this is definitely a challenge. I just wanted to mention this. Okay? And then the problem of citations and verifying them. Jayanta, you could probably relate to this a lot. Problem of citations on local language communities. Problem of citations. You cite a book, but the book is nowhere available in any of the indexes that we can get access to. You have to go to a library, check all the catalogs, and then go through everything, and you'd still be not able to find that book they have mentioned. There could be a case like that. For English, it's much better nowadays, you know, you get everything on Google Books itself. But yeah, you need have something to add about that?
You have
an inner?
Inner paper. So it's largest circulated paper called Inadu.
Okay, okay, yeah, I know about it, yes.
So it is not Unicode.
Yeah.
Okay, so we have converters available to Unicode.
Mm-hmm.
So I found a lot of articles would actually take content from the Inadu and convert it to Unicode and update in the Telugu, right? The way somebody want to search now, Inadu will not be visible because they don't have Unicode one. So how to handle that? We can't able to search. The text is copied from Inadu. We have to do reverse engineering. I mean, even the text is not searchable.
Connect with the interns at CIS who are very good these days. They are getting a lot of content, into the open. Jigova University made their encyclopedia open. I heard. So go talk to them. Ask them to put it up in a Creative Commons or supported license, and then copy it off from there and edit it and put it there.
But they denied. I mean, we asked for Inadu.
Take it through another channel. You could probably talk to Sunil about that. You know, take it through another channel. Talk to them. There's nothing like, you know, talking to people. You got to keep talking to them. Keep talking to them.
These things.
Who's that? What's that?
I'm asking, are you friends of Ramojirao?
Ramojirao. Somebody here must be.
Now, this trend is changing very fast. This problem, this Unicode ASCII problems. First of all, media.
No, this would, the discussion will. No, I wouldn't say it in public if it was like that. I was just kidding.
No, one more thing is possible.
Yeah.
A person might have painstakingly drafted one paragraph. You convert that paragraph into some diagram or picture. So probably your view is much more, whatever you are presenting is much more creative than the person who has originally written the text paragraph. Though probably he is the person who had the great idea and you are just presenting in a good form.
See, I'll come to that. I have a point written down about that. I'll come to that actually. What you're talking about is something that I've put a note about here.
Yeah.
The problem of citations though. Let's get to the problem of citations and verifying them. In local language communities, this is a big problem actually. And this needs to be countered. This needs to be countered. You haven't pointed
that
out.
That's what I am focusing on. I'm telling that trend is changing.
Tell me,
concept has to be updated.
Sorry?
That concept has to be updated.
Okay.
Local languages don't have the citation problem anymore like the way we used to experience until now. Things are changing, like the digital library of India. Many regional languages, a lot of digitization is taking place. They are available, many of them are open sources. The problem is actually for us to find the links, find the information, connect to the site.
Basically references. References to trustable sources.
We are not talking about plagiarism, we are not talking about copy pasting.
Alright, I get that.
Link and site.
Yes.
So the only thing we need to take
That's good that you added information about this. It's very good that you added information. It's basically about references. Basically about referring to a source which is trustable, which is trustworthy. Okay? What is trustworthy is again debatable. What can be done to modify the way, again, it comes back to the point which I said earlier, which I made earlier. We can't just copy stuff from English Wikipedia and use it the same. This is good. Good thing
so
that you mentioned.
We are not trying to copy paste and put the content here.
Mm-hmm.
We are actually linking to the original source and the source is available online. So this way it's even getting more authentic. And then
that's also a very good point actually to what you are talking about. Linking to actual sources. See, suppose you found that Enadu page very useful. You can add a link to that page on that related topic. Go there and add a link. Done. People will get that. Because even to this day, I'll tell you what.
When we done this, they are updating.
No, I'll forget about what I'm trying to say. No. Wait. Let's not get into a debate right now. I have another important point that I was trying to make. See, people on English Wikipedia who have been exposed to English Wikipedia for a long time, nowadays we don't use it as a source itself. We don't use it as a source at all. We use it as a starting point for our research. We use it as a starting point. We used to use the links a lot. What makes English Wikipedia more important, useful for us, are the links at the bottom of the page. I'm used to now getting to the bottom of the page the first thing and then checking the links. And then getting back to the article and seeing what these guys have written. And I see the template on the top saying whether this article is being cited properly or all the things that have been done. So that's how we get started now. So adding a link is very good. See, adding a link will not be a problem for them, because if you add a link, their search engine ranking will improve. So they'll always be happy to have more links. I've seen that on Kannada Wikipedia and elsewhere. People come and add links with, you know, even if we delete them, they come and keep adding links. Yeah, they keep adding links. They'll keep adding links. They want more search engine ranking. Yeah, they keep adding it. Let them add it. Huh? As long as it is not inappropriate, it's not going to something that's not related, we should be a little welcoming for certain things at
the initial
time.
Blogs.
Sorry?
Blog. Most of the people, they write something.
No, blogs, again, see, those are the challenges. I'm going to talk about those here. There are some weird scenarios. I'll talk to you about that. There are a lot of weird scenarios, not just linking to the blog. Linking to the blog is one nuisance. There are many more nuisances, but you have to deal with it in a calm way. And you have to deal with it in a practical way. You can't just carry a sword and then go fighting with them. We can't do that. This is a community. We have to find out ways to address these issues in a proper way, okay, so that these guys are also not offended. We want everybody in the community. It's not like we'll drop them off and not carry them along. We need to carry everybody along when if it comes to community. We need everybody, even the person you have fought with the last week. We need them to be contributing, okay? We need everyone to be contributing. So if they come and add a link to their blog, tell them nicely that adding link to the blog is not as per the policy, and point them to the relevant policy note. Tell them that. And tell them nicely. If they don't do it nicely, bring the SISOP into the picture and then get them to do whatever is required. As per the policy. As per the policy, whatever needs to be done can be done. If somebody spits on your car, you tell them nicely not to do that. If they keep doing that, what else you have to do? You have to do that. That's it. Right? Then let's get to the weird scenarios part. This is very interesting. I, for instance, found on Kannada Wikipedia that a lot of people are creating biographical pages on their own name. They're writing about themselves. I was like, what the hell is going on here? Yeah, I was just looking at it yesterday, the day before yesterday, and I was like, 2-3 active contributors have biographical pages about themselves, and every day, after all the editing they do, they go to their page and add 2-3 lines and then sleep off. Wow. This is one of the weirdest scenarios I've ever seen. There was another scenario that I came across on Kannada Wikipedia. One person was a big movie fan.
But generally, I don't know about Kannada, I've not seen that. Telugu and all, if anybody does that, not just the Wikipedians, any author, recently one prominent author from Srikakulam, created his own page and we deleted it. Right?
That's the way it should be. That's why I'm saying weird scenario.
Made a culture.
See, what happens is somebody in the community should point it up and put up a policy page. Somebody in the community should point it up, become the bad person for at least a bit. It's like being nice to them. You should be nice to them and tell them that you're not supposed to write a biographical note about yourself on your own. You should tell them that. But what happens in the community is nobody wants to be a bad person with anybody. They want to be in good terms with everyone. That can't happen in the community. You have to tell them nicely. Like, this is like, if somebody else is spitting on somebody else's car, say, dude, that's not good. Now, saying that is something that you have to do in a community place. In India, it just goes on. Everywhere. Somebody
not
students
the first
and then
turn.
We see and then we take a stroll and go away.
Not
yeah?
the first turn. In Malayalam, this is well structured now. Like,
that's how it should
there,
be.
There are
sure.
some users who are VIPs, you know, like well-known people. They deserve their own articles. We say, okay, there will be an article for you. They don't want themselves to be written, but we will write. But we say, don't intervene. You have nothing to edit on this page. You are not going to edit on this page. We will take care. Unless something negative comes, they report to us, then we correct it.
That's how it should be. And that's how the policy should
but
be.
But they are, at the same time, they are also users, active users sometimes.
That's how it should be, and that's how the policy should be structured. I'm talking about weird scenarios. I've seen a lot of weird scenarios. Nowadays, it's more structured because there are a lot more people editing on each Wikipedia. Telugu, for instance, didn't have any active Wikipedians when I was editing. I was editing on Kannada Wikipedia long back. I was very active there. I used to spend from the time from morning 7 o'clock to evening 7 o'clock in the night time. I used to work on Kannada Wikipedia. At that time, there were no contributors on Telugu Wikipedia. Now we have contributors on Telugu Wikipedia. So more people will bring in more structure. More people will bring in more, energy to get these things done, get things like this done. So weird scenarios will vanish away in some quantity at least, right? Now I'm just talking about weird scenarios. You need to make sure that the people who are getting into this are at least given a hint about probable weird scenarios. There's a huge community.
And
there are a lot of things that
happened.
Yeah.
The people get sensitive over
there. I'm coming to that. I have that point written down here.
Okay.
I had a similar experience as well. I had to fight and then they said, you belong to this caste and that's why you... I was reminded about my caste on that day. I was like, wow, I do belong to this caste. I didn't remember that. Now, for my caste, I'm supposed to wear some sort of stuff and all. I don't know about that. I got to know about that through searching something online that day. It's all learning. That's a good learning. Yeah, that was a good learning. You always need to take positive things away from that and forget the negative aspects of it. Anyway, there was another instance where one movie fan was creating a lot of stuff on Kannada Wikipedia. He ended up creating thousands of movie stubs, and whenever you clicked on random article, it would show up a movie stub. He does it even to this day. And I just spoke to him nicely and told him, why, if you keep doing this, people will lose interest. I told you, the necessity is very important. The health of the thing is very important. The Wikipedia or the resource that you're creating should be useful for people. They need to keep coming back to this. But when they see just this, this is available on other websites as well. They don't see any added value here. So they need to see added value here for their research or anything. So I told that he did not stop. I just stopped talking to him about that later. So that there are some scenarios. You want to add something?
Scenario,
to
scenario.
Yes?
So there's one Telugu called Guinnessman.
Yeah.
But somehow these people able to link to English Wikipedia. Somebody search for Guinnessman. They landed in English Wikipedia, Mahesh Babu movie. Businessman. Still it's been existed. Even I requested a couple of times, businessman must be something. They told that, okay, someone, I don't know who edited that term, but the moment when you type businessman, you landed up in a Wikipedia, which is Mahesh Babu movie. It's right about all the stuff about Mahesh Babu. But how to communicate that? I mean,
it's very difficult to communicate that. It's very tricky issue as well, because, you know, with movie, they can come and approach you offline and say, why are you doing that? The article has to stay like that. It's supposed to be about my favorite hero. In fact, one of the guys who was Badani, I guess, on English Wikipedia, was literally chased on outside his house for doing something on Wikipedia. This is very famous, actually. He was literally chased offline. This is offline. I'm talking. Whatever happens online is online. That's perfect. Forget it. Nobody is going to read those discussion pages. Even if they spit at you, it will be there on the page and nobody will read that later. You think that somebody will read it, but then it goes down in the archive, nobody reads it. But what if they come offline and hurt you in other ways? That's a different tricky thing. So you've got to approach it in a proper way. Okay? You need to make proper arrangements for whatever you're getting into and then tackle all these things. It's a difficult thing. It's, of course, a big challenge. I've encountered that as well. See, what happens is for us, it's about generating that, it's about building that resource. For them, it's not that. they might also have that that intention, but when it comes to their favorite hero, heroine, or favorite topic, they are very protective. I'm going to talk about that in a bit, okay? There are a lot of challenges. Let's not get into that. I know challenges are a very favorite topic for discussion. Maybe a discussion should happen about those things. And before they get into this, the challenges should be listed out. And because I'm pretty sure I'm still a very newbie in many of these things. I'm not very experienced in tackling so many of those issues. When we get more people in, when we get experience in, probably you could probably give us some insight, okay? I'm still 30 something, okay? So I've still got a lot to learn in my life. Some of these things, the tackling people like that, like he mentioned, is something to do with our real life skills as well, and how to handle people, right? How to be nice and still be able to handle that. So this discussion should happen on that. I can't give answers or solutions, but I'm just putting out those things on the desk, all right? The other challenges, of course, tops, content that is not up to the mark. Content that's not up to the mark, how do you change it? Sometimes they end up putting anything whatsoever, and if you start editing it, it's more difficult than translating any highly technical article. It's very difficult to improve an article that's very bad. It's like editing someone else's code. As a programmer, I know how difficult it is to edit someone else's messy code. It's very difficult. In that time, you could write it on your own, but on Wikipedia, you can't do that. If you write it on your own, the next day it comes and says, why did you erase that? Am I not a contributor? Have I not contributed anything here? It was something valuable. Why did you erase that? So you have to be very accommodate. You have to accommodate them as well here. In my office, if somebody does not write a good code, I just sit there and rewrite it in a bit and then say, you haven't done these things, so you correct it all. But on Wikipedia, you can't do that. You can't take that privilege. You don't have that privilege. So you have to address that. Now, editing madness. Some people go on a rampage of editing because they want to increase their edit counts. There are people who are edit count freaks. They want to increase their edit counts. It needs to be on the top. That's what they want. They want the edit count to be on the top because they, anytime they fly off a mail, they should say, I'm the best, I have a lot of editing counts under my belt. That's what they need to say. There are people who are go on a rampage editing articles just to edit it, whether or not it requires an editing. I'm not a big fan of that at all, okay? And people should not be decided based on their editing counts or based on their activity, because activity does not determine the value that they have added. The actual value is the stuff that they have added on an article. One edit by a person who has added a lot of stuff to an article will count as just one edit, nothing else. So how many such edits have we ignored? Stop promoting people on edit count. Stop promoting people based on their activity. Promote people who are adding value. You people who are part of local language communities, you are the best people to judge who's adding value to the community. You can see that. Even if you have difference of opinion with those people, you can at least say that, yes, this guy has done a good job. Okay, whatever is the difference between me and him, he's done a good job, is what we can say, right? Everybody has difference of opinion, but then we can say that this guy has done a good job. We can see the value. It should be based on that value, not based on the edit counts. Editing madness is something that we can't, and we can't tackle right away. But this is a challenge, it is a challenge because many people resort to that. Many people resort to editing rampage. Yeah? And then the bots. Bots are a tricky thing. They request permission to you. If you're a sysop on any project, they request permission with you first. If you don't grant permission, they'll go contact the steward, get access, and then start running bots. So who gives the clearance? The steward does, and he may not be knowing what's going on in the local language community. Usually they don't actually. They let the local sysops decide. If the local sysops do not respond, they usually take it up. But if they run bots which are not properly authorized to make changes, it will mess up everything. It will mess up the articles on just one click. It's like running a bulk updating script on the entire Wikipedia and spoiling it, destroying it within no time. But there are good there is a good side of it as well. You can use bots to do very good things. So you have to make proper judgment. This is nevertheless a challenge, because bots are to be used properly. Using it properly and devising a proper policy for usage of bots is nevertheless a challenge. Now, when there is lesser participation in communities, some of you guys may have experienced this, when there is lesser participation in communities, this is very true in smaller communities in Indian language Wikipedias, there is no consensus about stuff. To build consensus, it is very much, building consensus is very much impossible. It's quite impossible sometimes. Because if there are three people and each person goes on his own direction, where is the consensus? How do you get consensus? Where is the majority? You have to find another person who comes here and signs on behalf of you, which is not good. So lack of consensus with lesser participation is always a challenge. And many people resort to many other ways of bringing in consensus, which is not a good idea, because we are not fighting for anything here. We are trying to build something here by getting consensus by wrong means. It's not going to help us in any way, right? What is it going to do for us? We are just contributing here, not getting any, you know, we are not conquering a nation by doing that. So lack of consensus is always a challenge. Dealing with sensitive socio-cultural scenarios, like you mentioned, dealing with sensitive socio-cultural scenarios, like the Sai Baba scenario that my colleague mentioned just now. There are many more like that. I was reminded about my cash and so many things like this happen a lot. It was just one instance I talked about. Lots of stuff like this keep happening every day. They target you like anything. So I was the founder of Sampada, a community, and then there was an article about another community on Wikipedia. I edited something. I don't remember what I edited. I took the stats from the source. I referred the stats from the source and verified it and corrected it as per the source. And they came in and said, you are managing the other community, that's why you're jealous, so you fixed it. I said, no, I fixed it because it has changed in the source, I just updated it. I never thought about that when I was editing it, honestly. And these guys just said, you manage this community, that's why you're doing that. So there is you're an easy target, that's always there. But with maturity, with a bit of diplomacy and being nice to people, you can handle that. But it's got to do with how you are handling your real life, in your real life, how you're handling these things as well matters. Because at one time, even I was not very comfortable handling all these things. But it's nevertheless a challenge. It's nevertheless a big challenge, dealing with socio-cultural scenario sensitive ones. Now, this is a big challenge whatsoever. Now, people who argue, they just waste your time. You know, the time that I would have probably spent adding some value to an article, they start an argument and you have to respond on Wikipedia for certain things. Or else you will be, you have to respond on certain things. There is no going away with it. You'll get stuck, succumbed into it. So, argumentative individuals, watch out for them. And ask people whom you're training to watch out for them as well. You have to be very thoughtful in how you spend your time on these things. You have to be very thoughtful in how you spend your time on this. Sometimes it's okay to ignore some of these people, and you can ignore them or bring someone else. On English, I always used to bring Sundar in because he was very good with handling people. Sundar and Guru Brahma, right, were very good. I used to bring them in. Whenever somebody used to argue with me, I would probably put up my justification and then bring these senior guys in because they were very good handling these people. And they were good with English as well. I was not very good with English, so I was like pretty anxious to write back to them. So I used to bring them in. So bring people like them. Or get people whom you're training to bring people like them. Or maybe you yourself. And I think anonymous editing is not that much of a big thing nowadays. But earlier we had a big issue with anonymous editors, spoiling everything whatsoever. They would just blank a page and then go run away. Keep reverting that. That's the 2-hour job for me every day. that's not a good that's not a productive spend of your time at all. That's not productive at all if you're spending your time on any of the projects. And time wasters and troublemakers, you got to steer away from them. If you want to add any value to the project, you got to give clues to the people whom you are bringing up to watch out for these people as well. Yeah. Now, takeaways for you guys as trainers. This is the most important part for you. I don't think this comprehensively covers what it is for you guys, but then I have put in my bit. Now, promote culture of volunteering. That's very important on Wikipedia. If Wikipedia is to grow, promote the culture of volunteering. Volunteering is all about it. You know, I work with a lot of nonprofits in US, and they thrive with volunteering. They thrive. People volunteer for each and everything. They help out with each and everything. It's whether distributing food during the floods or doing something else. People who are in highest positions, they come down, they spend their time volunteering. Volunteering, it's all about volunteering here in a Wiki scenario. It's all about volunteering. Promote the volunteering culture. It involves identifying the resourceful people. If you find someone who's resourceful, identify them, encourage them a bit more. Even if they do not agree with you on certain topics, don't worry about it, but encourage them. Go put up a message on their user talk list saying, talk page saying, welcome to the community, here's what you can do. If you need any help, feel free to contact me. Even if they don't like me, even if I'm not a big fan of Narendra Modi and somebody else is, it's okay. They're entitled to have their opinion about something. It's okay, go talk to them. It's not that we have to fight offline as well, just because we have different opinions. That's not that. Go place a friendly note on the user page, talk to them, give them encouragement. Find the resourceful people. If you find that they are editing well, go encourage them a bit more, motivate them. Go talk to them, encourage them a bit more. If somebody adds good content in Sanskrit, for instance, Shubha, go promote them, because that initial encouragement means a lot to them. That means a lot. On Sampada as well, I do the same thing. Some people who came to Sampada adding articles initially, I used to encourage them and promote them to the featured article section. And I would say, you're doing good, please write more. They would write more, and some of them are now writing to some well-known newspapers and all that. And they say, you are the one who encouraged me to do it. There's a lady from US who's a doctor who says, I was very anxious to write in Kannada, but I started out here and today I'm very confident to write because Hari encouraged me a lot. She says, Mr. Nadi helped me a lot. So she's older than me, but she respects me for whatever I do. So this one will go a long way, they'll remember you. This morning when I came down, he said hi to me and said, you're the one who you and Anirudh started me on Wikipedia. That means a lot to us. I train a lot of people in my office who remember me after going to several other companies. They say, the stuff that you told me when I was there helped me a lot. So this is the same way, you're mentoring people in some ways. So it helps you. Yeah? Identifying them is not tricky, it's easy. You can see who's adding more more value to articles, so you can identify them pretty easily. Yeah? And identifying resources who can help you otherwise as well, like the graphic work, and if you see someone who's doing good graphic somewhere, you can see them, or if you see someone who's contributing good photographs to Commons, you can see them doing that and then say, why don't you take a photo of this topic whenever you're there and add it to Commons? You can say that and promote them in some ways. Now, motivating individuals to take up tasks based on their strengths is very important. This is one of the quite obvious things in anything that we're doing. We should encourage them to work to their strengths. If you ask a guy who's good with graphics to redesign the community portal, it involves HTML, and he doesn't know that, right? So it wouldn't work out. But if you ask him to put up some neat graphics for the community page, he will do that. So it helps a lot. That's a big takeaway. And the whole thing, the community, the group, should work as a collective. It's very important. It should work as a collective. When I say collective, it means it is collective. It should work like a collective. Okay? Between all the differences, it should work as a collective. Very important. Next. You should assert importance of leadership skills. Okay, you might ask me, what has leadership skill got to do with all this? It is important, yeah? You should show your leadership skill when you're editing a Wikipedia or training these people, you know, get them to imbibe some skills that will help them resolve disputes. We were talking about disputes, the way to handle all these things. That comes only by improving your skills of leadership, of some real life skills as well. It's very much required. Because sometimes you get depressed when people do that online. Somebody flames you online, you'll be depressed. But if you're a mature individual, you'll just take it in a normal way. It's okay. If they have said something, they've said something. I've given my justification. And you'll move on, right? But many people can't, because on Wikipedia, you wouldn't believe it. There are kids from school who are editing a lot on English Wikipedia. You wouldn't know that, because they're, all I always see is IDs there. So you have to be very careful there. And if you use proper skills, you can address them all better and still be friends with them. So good reasoning is required. Neutral point of view is an essential thing. Neutral point of view. Many people editing on Wikipedia, they don't share an NPO. But the NPO is absolutely essential. Okay? And then firm, assertive, yet firm, friendly approach. If you're saying don't spit there, you should be firm saying don't spit there. It should be firm, assertive, but it should still be friendly. You shouldn't be rude. Hey, what the hell are you doing? Why are you spitting there? That's not a good thing. That shows your maturity. If you are a mature individual, you will be sought out for in a community, whether it is Wikipedia or elsewhere. If you are a mature individual and if you are addressing these things properly, you will be the most sought out for person. I bet Sundar was the most sought out for person when he was editing on English Wikipedia. He was flooded with requests to solve disputes with on this, that and everything. He's still the most, he's still very interesting individual. I keep going back to him for advices and all that. So there are people like that on English Wikipedia. There are people like that on many communities. That has happened because they have adapted to these things. They have good reasoning, okay? Even if they don't subscribe to your views, they have good reasoning to talk about that. They reason well. Now, knowing when to get into an argument is a very important thing that anybody contributing to Wikipedia should have. Don't just get into argument. Think about it. Don't get into argument for the argument's sake. If there is something that needs to be argued about, then argue, or else the discussion page will go on for 4 pages. In that time, you could have added a lot of value to the article itself rather than the discussion page, right? All the time you spend there. And the same with the people you are training. If they get into arguments, all the stuff, all the effort that you have put to train them is gone waste, because they are wasting their time discussing and arguing there rather than adding more value to the article, right? Yes, the next takeaway is pushing contributors to not be protected. Yeah, this is the thing that we were talking about. Not being protective about articles. You said that there's a paragraph.
Yeah.
There's a paragraph that I have written. Somebody else comes and changes it, completely spoils it. I've seen that happening.
No, what they do is change the form.
They do that.
That's an excellent thing.
They do that.
Convert in the form of a table or maybe some graph or some sort of illustration. Then it is much more presentable. Probably people will say that I have said something wonderful than what you have originally said.
They do
and
that.
There is no acknowledgement.
They do that. They do that. That's a given. They do that. They do that a lot on all language communities. This keeps happening a lot. Again, you have to deal with it nicely. And then you have to go with this process. Deal with it nicely, or bring someone who can solve the dispute and make a proper statement saying, no, that's not good, this is the right thing. So you have to bring in that. You can't get into argument for that. If you get into argument, it will be one-on fight. Yeah? You'll be taking them on. Don't fight. Don't worry if somebody takes it off, because everything is there in the revision. You can restore it anytime. Okay? You can restore it anytime in your lifetime. It's there. The revision, so you can go there and bring it back. This happened to a friend of mine. My friend Pramod, Pomri, who was actually working with Mahiti earlier. He's a very decent and very silent guy. Okay? His dream for a while was to get the Economy of India page to the featured article status. He should have worked on it all night, you know, you can't believe it. I couldn't believe it. He worked for 2 weeks straight to get that page to the front featured article status. I was flabbergasted. I said, you're not a, you're, how are you interested in economy? Why are you doing this? I asked him. No, I want this on featured article status. So he made such a lot of compromises. If somebody would say, go change it, it's not proper, he would say, sure, sir, I'll do it. We'll go and do it. And not sir, but he would say, sure, I'll do it. Sure, I'll change it. Sure, I'll do this. He worked on that like this for 2 weeks. Somebody came just the day before it was to be designated as the candidate for FA. He came in, somebody came in and took away the most important paragraph. If I was, at that time, I was not as wise as now, but at that time, I would have gotten offended. I would have thought, oh, who's this guy to revert it back? I'll go and revert it back. I would have done that, but he didn't do it. He went to the discussion page and said, and wrote there, saying, you have removed this paragraph. Please let me know why you have done so. And if there is anything wrong in that, let me know and I'll correct it off. But this is a very important paragraph that needs to go into the article. And this article is to be designated for the FA candidate. So please help me with it. And then he came down and said, oh, I didn't spot it. It was an accident. No, I removed it off. Things like this happen. And he was so mature in handling that, I was like, I was amazed. This guy, he set an example. That's how it should be. So it happens. The day before, and it became a featured article the next day. And we were very happy. We put a lot of articles to FA status on English related to Kannada and Karnataka. That was very nice. It was very interesting.
Sometimes these type of edits are more possible with people who hold advance rights, who have rolled back rights. Accidentally you click it. All the edits by one person will be going.
No problem. You can revert it back. MediaWiki is a very interesting
that
software.
That person should have that patience.
No. What happens is, these are things that can happen, you know. You say accident should not happen, accidents happen. Even if you have a lot of patience, you will end up hitting someone or other. It's not that we want to hit somebody. It will somehow scratch through somebody else's car. What can you do about that? Totally. It happens, this sheer happens, but we'll need to figure out a way to come out of that, that's it. Alright, coming back to this, understanding collaborative flow of work is very important. Understanding collaborative flow of work. When I say collaborative flow of work, this is the thing. The way I mentioned Pomri did it. That's the collaborative flow of work. You have to be nice to people and still get things done. Collaborative work is all about that. You have to sometimes lose your protection, you know, you lose your control over certain things and still not feel bad about them. Being nice to others is very important, and being open to feedback and changes is very important. And look for all-rounders. Looking for all-rounders is very important, because I used to find people who do a lot of work. They edit articles, they do graphics, they do that, they do this, they do everything. And they are very useful in communities when they are just being brought up. Okay, look for people who can do a lot of things, and they are like the most valuable resources you can never get, because they'll quickly do stuff. I found a lot of people around Wikipedia who are like very good with so many things. They look for them, be in touch with them. It helps a lot. And the same for the people whom you are training. You should tell them to look for people like this to connect with. Yet ensure distribution of tasks through discussion. The tasks should be distributed through discussion. It's not like I'll do this and I'll be the person who'll be doing all that. For instance, there's a news section. If somebody is doing that, somebody is more interested in helping out with that, you should be welcoming to them. Say, please come down. If you want to do it, do it. If they don't do it the way you want it, it's okay. Tell them nicely, this is the way it's being done, so please help out by doing it in the same way. But be welcoming. But distribute the task through discussions. Distribute it. Sometimes we become very protective and to keep doing the same thing of ourselves and say, you have nothing to do here, I'm doing the whole thing. Why are you changing it? That's not good actually. We should adapt ourselves to do that. Yeah. COTD and COTW. COTD is very very famous on English Wikipedia. Collaboration of the day. That has helped a lot for Wikipedia to grow. I've seen Wikipedia from the day when Village Pump was just being formed by, you know, just being built by Angela. Angela used to spend a lot of time in the night, you know, reformatting, putting things together on Village Pump. But collaboration of the day helped a lot in bringing very good articles during the initial days of Wikipedia. That might help on language Wikipedias as well. Collaboration of the day. But if there is a lesser community and you can't afford to have collaboration of the day kind of things, you should at least have collaboration of the week kind of thing. I used to do that on Kannada Wikipedia. Collaboration of the week. Pick a topic for the week and then, you know, request everyone to add something to it. At least once or twice. Or any of the day. So that would help a lot in coming up with good articles. This improves the value of the project. See, always it's important to improve the value of the project. Improving the value of the project is the most important thing, then the number of articles. The number of articles, who are you kidding? How many? We can put any numbers. I can write a software today to increase the number of articles on Kannada Wikipedia, or nobody will question me until some time, till it trickles down to someone else. Article number of article count is not the status of health of Wikipedia. It's the actual visitors and the contributors that we have that should be scaled in.
Is it either or? Should it be an either or kind of thing?
See,
isn't there a mixed somewhere in between thing? Because if
you there is no definite scale.
If you don't have all the articles in Wikipedia, do you think the readers would come?
See, again, all articles is subjective, Vishnu. What happens is, what does the local language community need? For instance, the articles about movies, sure. They want to know who all acted in the movie, sure. Why not? In Kannada, people like to read a lot about the literature.
Yeah. Which I think it's often discussed at a great length and it's written in blogs. This is the article about Telugu Wikipedia community creating village articles using bots. It's all stub articles.
You want to increase the article count by any chance?
No, this was done around 2007 or 8.
2007, yes.
Yeah. So 19,000 articles were created, village articles. Almost one liner, two liners.
It's not good.
But no, please. But when I go to, when you are talking about Telugu community, I'm not really bothered about the India community, right? When I go and do presentations and I tell them, you can see your village on Wikipedia, they immediately go and search and they kind of build a connect even if there is single line. Okay? And they stay to the Wikipedia. And they go back and tell, at least I have seen instances. Okay? Tell 20, 30 people. Right? By, say, English Wikipedia standards, probably, you know, these number of articles may be seen as stubs, may see that this quality is diminishing,
mm-hmm.
but when you look at it from a community point of view,
mm-hmm.
what is more noteworthy
mm-hmm.
in a region
mm-hmm.
other than a village in that language?
Okay.
It's a definite this thing that one has to improve these articles. But I'm saying often this is seen as, you know, given as an instance, as a wrong instance of how not to increase the number of articles. I'm saying in Telugu community, so far,
yeah.
I'm sure Pranay Raj is one Wikipedian who got connected because he saw the Telugu, his village article. Yes or no? And it was a stub article.
Mm-hmm.
And he came on board, tried to improve it.
Mm-hmm.
I personally know, when I do whatever limited Wikipedia workshop that I do, people edit their village article and they move on. They're committed to, you know, contributing there, right? Imagine if that is not there. And people search in Google, they find so happy to discover that their article is there, you know, their village is there. So I'm saying, when we talk about, you know, I think somewhere we're losing the point about the relevance of a local language Wikipedia,
mm-hmm.
and when we are talking about quantity, you know,
all
definitely
right.
one should not go behind improving the quantity,
mm-hmm.
just the, you know, go to this thing,
mm-hmm.
but one should also try to look at it in that context.
Right.
You know, it cannot be a broad stroke remark that quantity is not important.
I agree with you, not fully though. I agree with you. See, what happens is, it's not a bad thing to create stops about villages. it's a bad thing to keep it in that way for years to come. Okay?
What is
I'll tell you what. Let me speak on this, okay?
According to my hunch.
No, let me speak on this. I'll just tell you.
Wikipedia gets more hits because people are searching for their villages.
No, I'll tell you what.
More and more.
Let me speak about this. See, when do we relate to things more? When we see things that we have seen. A photo of our something in our village, or anything that's very interesting about our village, anything that's to be known about our village or town. That is what relates us to the place more. No, let me speak about this, Vishnu.
Yeah.
Why don't we utilize that? We need to utilize that. Creating stubs is one thing. That's a good thing. Do it. But then, put all the efforts to improve the articles, to get these factors in. A photo from a village, a little interesting fact about the village, or these things. These efforts shouldn't stop. I'm not a big fan of people who just create stuffs and leave it at that. If they're doing that, they should take the responsibility of doing something else as well. This is like planting something, watering it the first day, and then leaving it there for its own sake. I wouldn't call that a forestation. I wouldn't call that afforestation.
No, but
let me continue what I'm trying to say. If you don't do it firsthand, if you don't do the improvement of that firsthand, you should at least ensure to put in a system which will continue and improve this on at a later time.
We have created a project. There is a framework that is created.
We made a simple article also. This is as per the guidelines of Wikipedia only. See, when it comes to village, name is not there. No one able to upload the photos. No one able to write anything about that.
But we cannot construct it
because we have small community. Now Unicode is there. Somebody searching on that one. We make sure that one they can land it. Maybe we can write about the 3 crore gods or 3 crore villages or something, right? One clarification before this discussion goes wayward, I want to get one clarification.
Where are we getting at with this?
No, I'm saying, take a broad stroke approach that going behind quantity is a bad thing. Is this what we are going to tell the community?
See, this is not a decision that I cannot take or you cannot take here sitting in this room. This is a decision that the community on each local language Wikipedia should take. So there is no point talking about that.
No, there is a point.
No, it's something about how to see. As Telugu Wikipedia done this and we are quite successful. So we just looking for, is there any advice to other communities? One other thing that I'm
very specific about is that. Don't use something that works on one Wikipedia to some other Wikipedia on some other Wikipedia as well, because the same thing may not work on all Wikipedias. Yeah. Every Wikipedia or every local language community, I talked about the same thing all this time. Every language community has its own. You have to deal with these things in their own way. Don't throw upon them something that they may not require. So each language community should come up to a consensus on this. You're not letting me speak, so I'm not going to. You got to let me speak, listen to me, and then you put out your question, I'll answer that. Is that a deal? Does that work for you? Yes. This is something that people on local language community should decide. We cannot decide sitting here. Whether it is good or bad is also something that we cannot decide. I put out my opinion saying that after doing that, if there is a continuation, that would be good for the Wikipedia. All of us are striving to make this better. We're not here to fight on something. We are striving to make things better. To make it better, what needs to be done. That's it. Yes, you have
Vishwa and Muzumal, let's give Vishwa one chance.
Yeah.
He's lifted the hand first.
Yes?
I think, we should not forget the first point. First point is very simple and single point. How do you get people into the honeypot? And whatever helps the honeypot works. And regardless of which community, it's a very general principle. Get the bees into the honeypot. And to do that, there may be sometimes you may have to devise a strategy. That strategy is not a decision-making process, it's a strategy process which we can evolve even here. which everyone can take into their community and distribute. The strategy is very simple. Why should people want to come to the Wikipedia? For example, Lal Rangeka Mot, this is the name of my gaon, my village. I see there is Har Rangeke Mot karke, there is another village, you know, the green village is there, and they have got three paragraphs, and I have got just one entry. It is just natural, I end up in Wikipedia someday, I go and search, Mera gaon ka nahi hai, my village is not there, but the other village seems to have some problems. He will take every struggle, because we are all, you know, very patriotic, to the village level, to the family level, to the clan level, to the individual. So we are scaling down and finding people. So we just create the space there and ensure that there is a gradual development, gradual foresting happening, taking place. And that growth is just like the theory of life, it automatically develops. What do we do in Malayalam? There are, you know, very strict notability terms in Malayalam. Even if a new person comes up and starts jotting down something, we say, is this film actor notable? Not every film actor, just because he's an actor, he can't be. That notability, we have certain put certain standards. One very liberal place where we have not at all, notability is a, you know, least concern is the village name, for example. Every village, if it gets in the Wikipedia, we just allow it. But immediately comes a small template. Really, this is not even a stub, we say it's a one-line article. And one-line articles are not promoted, they are kept in a particular category. Every year we have a one-line article removal project. At that time, they have to either go out of Wikipedia or get developed. And there's a notice period. And we see that within that 1 year, in fact, all of them has got some basic data, this population, boundary, neighboring villages, transportation, access, all of them. If my neighbor's village is not promoted, I might go and actually try to create that. And all these people, they go, they find the photographs, they upload, and it actually fuels a lot the community. So we have to see what is it part of the honeypot strategy. If it is there, it's better to even silently to promote that.
Okay.
That is about this particular.
Do you want to say something after this? If you're saying something after this, I need to say that I've overrun the time that was given to me. It's 12:30. I still need to get back. So you ask away your question.
Yeah,
and then
very
we'll
specific thing. Since I'm referring to Hindi Wikipedia.
Yeah.
I have some article on Fulla Nayak. Okay.
Okay.
It is just having two lines.
Mm.
The reason why this lady's article is there on this lady is not that she has done something very great, but because probably nature has gifted her with a long life.
Mm-hmm.
She died at the age of some 120 years.
Okay.
And as per the claim of her family members, she lived for 125 years.
Citation?
Now, that citation I have added, and the only thing which I could do to develop this article is having some info box person. Beyond that, we don't have any resources, any listing information about the family, any information about her life. So what should we deal with such types?
I'm not going to answer that. I don't have answers for that.
Yeah.
My opinion is that if you have
I think one thing that I can see here, and all these people are very interested in all this, there should be definitely be discussions about this. There should be elaborate discussions about this among them. They are very much interested. This is good science. These are good science. You guys should discuss this elaborately. You are here. You're staying here. It's not the same thing for me though. But you're staying here. You should discuss these things. You should find answers for this. I'm not here to give you answers. I'm here to point out stuff that I have observed from out of my experience. In this case, I haven't encountered something like this in my.
Bangalore, a case. There's a person claiming 117 years old.
I never wrote an article about that, or I never did that, so I wouldn't be able to help you there. Okay? But I'm pretty sure that the discussion should. I would recommend that these discussions should happen. You guys are here. Please discuss this. Please work it out. Yeah? Question? Related to this? Something else?
Overall. So
yes?
What to do when there is a fight within the community between 2 to 3 administrators and there is a...
Figure it out. Talk about that right here. Bring that out. There are a lot of administrators here. Talk about them.
And you had some strategies yesterday.
Yeah.
You were talking.
So that's your discussion. Discuss.
So
yeah? That's a very good thing. How many days have you been here? Last 2 days?
Two days.
You should talk about this over lunch, you know, or dinner. Dinner is fun with talk about fights. Very nice. Talk about it. Yeah? So, a virtual community place can help, is what I have found. A virtual community place like Village Pump. We called it Early Katte in Kannada. I don't know whether it's still there or not. We called it Early Katte for the simple fact that in Karnataka, in a village, people gather together below that early tree to discuss things, not near the village pump. In English culture, they gather around near village pump, it seems. But in Karnataka, it's Early Katte. So we used that concept and started doing it. Unfortunately, I couldn't put a lot of efforts there. Someone else did, which was pretty nice. I encouraged him a lot. He revamped the whole page and did a lot of work. But Community Place helps a lot. The help files are very important. Community Place is very important. Whoever comes in the first time, they wouldn't know where to go, what to do, how to write. Getting all these pages together, getting all this documentation together will really help, is what I found out. And collaboration of the week is something that helped a lot, so you should probably think about that. Now, another takeaway for trainers is being assertive about ethics. We talked about all this. Being assertive about ethics to new contributors will bring them up in a proper way. You know, respecting ethics, not removing paragraphs written by someone else laboriously, is part of the ethical commitment we have when working in a community. That's very important. If we enlighten them about all these things in the initial stages itself, there are going to be less problems later on. You guys are initiating people, or you're getting people initiated on stuff on Wikipedia. If you're telling them about this right away, it will help you a lot probably later in your own respective communities, isn't it? Next, the last mile. I may have told a few things from out of my opinion during this talk of mine, but it's not like that has to stand. The community stands. The people are the important. It's the people that's important. Now, there are certain other things that are more important that I just listed out, which is, you may call it my opinion as well. I, for one, am a big fan of spreading the wiki culture. The culture, it's what drew us towards Wikipedia during the initial days and kept it there for several years. That's what drew us together. Wiki culture, that's very important. Even to this day, I have very good friends from Wikipedia with whom I converse, and I share a certain sort of bonding with them because of this, because of the way we thought about things. So that's wiki culture, you know, volunteering, being nice to people, handling things in a proper, mature way, not getting into arguments for the argument's sake, being mature when having an argument, being not getting into debate voraciously, but getting into debate with certain takeaways. That's very important. Being a proper individual in many ways is very, the wiki culture is all about that, helping others, helping build something, helping build a knowledge base. It's a very good thing. That's about wiki culture. I want you guys to just note this down with a lot of assertion. Spreading wiki culture is very important. I, for one, feel that organic growth is better. We talked about stubs, creating a lot of articles and all that. I am a big fan of organic growth, not inorganic growth. We don't want to get on the next level before being prepared for the next level. We want to go to the next level after having prepared ourselves for the next level. Okay? Getting to 1 million articles is good, but what if the community is not prepared for it? Getting 1 million articles is good in terms of numbers, in terms of visitors, or whatever that is. What if the community itself is not prepared for it? Huh? It's like how Bangalore is growing today. We have a lot of growth, we are seeing everything growing up, we are seeing a lot of real estate projects coming up everywhere. The infrastructure is not prepared for it, isn't it? The infrastructure isn't just ready yet for that. Compare that to here, the community, it's good, it's nice to have a million articles on Kannada Wikipedia, but then if there isn't a community which can manage all that in a proper way, what's the deal? It won't be good. So I, for one, am a big fan of organic growth, not inorganic growth. Organic growth is better. Don't project yourselves or project the project's growth in terms of numbers, but in terms of value. In terms of value. A little website which is of great value will be, you know, will be given more importance than a website which has lots of articles, pages with less value. That's always true. Now, enthusiasm overrides challenges and technical difficulties. This is something that you need to remember. We are here because we share an enthusiasm about Wikipedia. If there are technical difficulties, if there are challenges, whatever the challenge may be, we are still here because we are more interested in this. We are interested in this. Enthusiasm overrides that. It's a very big takeaway. That's what I'm going to say in the last mile of this one. And I'm going to say good luck to you guys in bringing up more Wikipedians and improving the community in this country. Let this go well. Yeah. Thank you.